FDA requires a four-letter suffix be associated with the non-proprietary name so that the various biosimilars can be distinguished from one another. We've asked pharmacists this, both in a formal survey that we did of 401 pharmacists in the U.S., as well as at a variety of continuing education programs that we've done around the country. And pretty consistently, about 75% or more of these pharmacists, when asked, agree that distinguishable non-proprietary names are important.
But if you ask preferences, pharmacists overall prefer having that distinct name. And part of the reason, or some of the reasons that they share about why, is because if you are working in a system and they have preference for a particular product, so a particular manufacturer is their preferred agent. If you use a universal name, your system may not be able to pick up that you want the preferred agent as you come through. The same goes for if you're reporting something on either an adverse event or a new start for a patient and you want to know explicitly what product they're using. If you use a universal generic-like name, you can lose that within their systems and within the electronic health records that they work in. And so the preference is that by having that distinct name, now you can more easily track the specific product being used and being prescribed, and the same goes for what is being dispensed at the pharmacy.
Well, pharmacists want to be using the same vocabulary as the prescribers are using. And they want to be able to know what's been prescribed so that they can provide the patient the medicine that's been prescribed. In the case of biosimilars, these are not identical medicines. They're not like generic drugs where simple molecules, one can substitute one for the other in the interest of saving money. It's interesting, if we look around the world, there's a variety of different naming schemes that have been proposed, some of which use letters and numbers, some of which have been proposed to use prefixes, some don't have any distinguishing names at all, and some countries are trying to make a decision as to whether they should have distinguishable non-proprietary names.
It's about pharmacovigilance, trying to make sure that we can really track what products are being used and the patient knows what specific product they're using, so if they were to have anything come up with it, they can report back on the specific product, not a general overall product like you would normally see with a generic name that would occur.
It's important because of the approval process for the pharmacist and the physician to monitor these patients very carefully to make sure that these similar products that aren't identical achieve the desired therapeutic effect, both in terms of their effectiveness and their safety. And if there's a problem with effectiveness and safety, we know exactly what medicine that the patient was prescribed and what they received.